Hello, my name is Tyler Provick from the General's Tent, tyler.provick.ca. I'm back once more with another General's Tent painting video. This time I'm continuing work on my Infinity Nomad Zond Remote from Corvus Belli. Based on the little feedback I got on my last video, I've tried to increase the magnification or get closer to the miniature in order to show more detail of what I'm doing. Unfortunately, this caused some problems where the miniature wasn't always in the frame. I apologize for when the miniature goes out of frame. I try to keep things as centered as possible, but when I was in the middle of painting, I would often lose track of what I was doing. I'm using the same technique from my last video, starting with a base of dark sea gray and light turquoise from Vallejo Model Color. I've mixed 5 shades in my palette, going from darkest to lightest, using black to darken and white to lighten. I then apply these, starting with the darkest, to the miniature. I don't wash my brush between colors. I simply get some more of my brush, wipe a little bit off, and apply it to the miniature. This is going to create a rough blend, which I will then, as you'll see later in this video, come back and smooth using thinner versions of the colors I'm using. In order to get the shadow under the front nose piece here, I quickly mixed some black into my darkest shade and applied it on the inside. I then would lighten that using the darkest version of my shade, going up to my second darkest version to create a little bit of a gradient inside as a shadow. Now that the first layer of paint has had a bit of time to dry, I'm going back in, once again from darkest to lightest, and reapplying my gradient. Since the paint I'm using is just slightly translucent, this buildup of color is required to get coverage over the gray base coat, and also soften some of the transitions. Now I've taken some of the lightest color on my palette and put it in a new paint well. I've also added some white and water in order to create a translucent glaze that I can use to start building a brighter highlight at the top. The translucent glaze will also help smooth out the transitions I've created with my earlier wet blending. This is very similar to the technique of many glazes, where a color is slowly built up using very translucent glazes. I will do the same thing with the darkest color by adding a little bit of black and water to it, and also my middle tone with just water. This lets me smooth out all the transitions and get to a point where I can't see any seams in my blends. This is where I started to get really involved in the miniature, working on the transitions, and started to not pay as much attention to my placement of my miniature for the camera. A lot of the pauses you see that I've cut out in this video are me blowing on the miniature to dry the layer so that I can apply the next one. Oftentimes, paint, especially when very thinned, appears much lighter than it actually is until dried. You got to be careful to not use the wet paint as your guide for color matching. This is what makes the many glazes technique so good. Because you're slowly building up color, you're not trying to match specific shades for each part of the transition. It's a lot more controllable and it can be done. Better painters can do it faster, but anyone can do multiple glazes of very thin color. Slowly build up a transition. While I was painting this section of the miniature, I found the legs that I had already attached to really be in my way. I can only imagine the difficulty I'll be having to get the inner body of the miniature painted. It really pays to plan ahead your sub-assemblies. I was hoping to be able to use the unpainted miniature in a game. I never ended up using it that way, so I really should have left the legs off. Other than coming back for some point highlights and edging, this part of the miniature is finished. The total video length before I edited it was about 18 minutes. So it took me 18 minutes to get a nice transition, good blend on this part of the miniature. Here's a still image of the miniature as I left it. It will look much better once I darken the eyes, add some shading and spot highlights there. The next stage will be to move on to the main body, which is mostly hidden by the legs. I won't do that on video. It takes a lot of time and it will be very hard to see anyways. So the next video you'll see will most likely be painting the leg sections. This has been Tyler Provick from the General's Tent, tyler.provick.ca. If you've enjoyed my video, please leave a comment or like it, or share it with someone else who might enjoy it as well. I do plan to make some more. In the meantime, have a great week.